Hello and welcome you once again in this new session of civics, and today we are going to start with the chapter number 1, that is our constitution. So now let's start with the constitution. The constitution of India came into effect on 26th of January 1950 when India became a sovereign democratic republic of India. Constitution is a comprehensive document containing the sets of rules that describe the rights and duties of citizens. It regulates the position and the power of the three organs of the government, that is the legislature, then judiciary, the executive. Enactment of the Indian Constitution. We have studied in the freedom movement of India that the cabinet mission arrived in India in 1946 and put forward a set of proposals to meet the demands of the freedom fighters. On these proposals involved the setting up of the Constituent Assembly, whose members were to be elected indirectly by the provincial legislative assemblies, that is lower house only. Election to the provincial assemblies were completed in July 1946. The princely states were represented by the members of nominated by the rulers of these states. The constituent assemblies of the undivided India consisted of 389 members, 292 elected and 93 nominated by the princely states, from the chief commissioner provinces. Formation of the Constituent Assembly. The first sitting of the Constituent Assembly was held in December 9, 1946. It was held at the presence of the Central Hall of the Parliament and was presided over by Dr. Sachidanand Sinha, the oldest sitting member of the Central Assembly, on December 11, 1946. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected the president of the Constituent Assembly. The Muslim League boycotted the Constituent Assembly to demand the creation of the separate state called Pakistan. Consequently, the member representing the territories which went to Pakistan withdrew from the Constituent Assembly of India. As a result, the membership of the Constituent Assembly of India stood to 299 against the original of 389 members. And were actually presented on the November 26, 1949 and append their signature of the constitution finally passed. Dr. Rajendra Prasad continued to the president of the Constituent Assembly. Between December 9, 1946 to August 14, 1947, the assembly held 5 sessions. Composition of the Constituent Assembly. The wide range membership of the Constituent Assembly gave the representation of all shades. The cabinet mission planned to ensure the representation of 3 categories, the general category, Muslims and Sikhs. Congress leader had, and however, ensured that the communities like Anglo-Indians, Indian Christians and scheduled castes and scheduled tribes got representation. The Anglo-Indians were represented by the Frank Anthony and S.H. Prater, the Indian Christians by Dr. H.C. Mukherjee and Joseph D. Souza, and the Parsis by Dr. H.P. Modi. Through the Muslim Leagues had boycotted the assembly, there were still 2 members, Zafar Imam and Muhammad Sadaullah, who represent the Muslim community. The Sikhs were represented by Sardar Hukum Singh and Ujjal Singh. It came to be said that the Constituent Assembly was truly a national in character. Now, objective resolution when the Constituent Assembly started working for the drafting of the Constitution. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru proposed the objective resolution on December 13, 1946. The resolutions were free India will nothing but a republic. The ideals of the social, political and the economic democracy would be guaranteed to all the people. The republic would grant fundamental rights to citizens. The state would safeguard the rights of the minorities and the backward classes. And the objectives resolution was passed by the Constituent Assembly. Drafting committee, the Indian Independence Act 1947, which were two independent states, India and Pakistan. This legal sanction enabled the Constituent Assembly to function after the India's independence, and the drafting committee was under the chairmanship of Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, was set up in August 29, 1947 and was entrusted with the task of drafting the committee. Dr. Ambedkar constituent to the Indian Constitution. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, popularly known as the Baba Saheb, was one of the architects of the Constitution of India. In order to shape India into a complete sovereign democratic republic, in which the liberty and the dignity of the individual ensured along with the national integrity, Baba Saheb incorporated the following principle. First, made the Indian constitution workable, flexible and strong enough to hold the countries together both in peace and war, provided the special safeguard to the minorities and certain classes who are socially and educationally backward, then incorporated the right of constitutional remedies, then single citizenship, single judiciary and uniformity in fundamental law to integrate Indian society. Time taken. It was nearly 3 years for the Constituent Assembly to finally pass the Constitution. At the time of the signing, the Constitution consisted 395 articles and 8 schedules. Implement of the Constitution. After signing the Constitution, only the clauses relating to the citizenship came into the force immediately. This was to enable person displaced as the result of the partitions to right themselves. The Constitution was adopted, the passes by the Constituent Assembly on November 26, 1949. The Constitution as a whole came into the force with 26th of January 1950. With the coming into the force, the Constitution, C. Raj Gopalachari became the Governor General. He replaced Lord Mountbatten. The Constituent Assembly became the Provincial Parliament until the new general election was held in 1951 to 1952. Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was the President of the Constituent Assembly, took over as the President of Indian Union. Significance of January 26. The date January 26, 1950 was the commencement of the Constitution was specially selected because of its historical importance. At Lahore session of the Congress was held in December 29, a resolution was passed which declared Purna Swaraj or complete independence on 26th of January 1930. Was fixed as the first independent day, which was to be so celebrated every year since Then the day was celebrated as an Independence Day up to 1947. On achieving independence, 15th August 1947 became the Independence Day. January 26th was designated as a Republic Day. So that's all for today's session. We will meet in our next session with a new topic. Till then, have a nice day and take care of your health.